BronxnetOPEN.NYC takes the average New York City citizen and turns them into a filmmaker with the creation of the city's first interactive map. The site allows New Yorkers to take their cameras or smartphones and become filmmakers. They want to encourage everyone to capture stories and real-life moments of New York City. Co-founder and filmmaker Alex Kalman is here to explain MyBlockNYC and where he sees the site going in the next years. Alex, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you. Can you tell me about the site? I went on it yesterday and I was looking at it. It's kind of cool. You see stuff from subways to random stuff from people's apartments.
Yeah. Well, the notion of the site is that maps can do more than just give you directions or show you where to shop or show you the kind of overlaying grid of a city. Within a map, there's all these stories that are happening from the people. So my block is trying to really not just show a map on a superficial level, but really show a map from the human perspective. So we can all really explore a city in a intimate way so that we have the feeling of being able to walk through the city streets as though we were actually in New York, even if we're not in New York.
So we're taking a look at the grid right now. That's how it looks. There, obviously, this is a new interactive map. So over time, it'll grow and we'll have tons and tons of video. Where do you see this going and how did you come up with this idea?
Well, right now, we're really focusing in New York. You know, we're all born and raised in New York City. We love the city. We love the energy of the city. So we really want to make a product for New York City's and New Yorkers to be able to express themselves and express their own city so that they can define their own city rather than a single movie or a news program defining their city. You know, this is a chance for them to kind of take it into their own hands. In the next year, who knows? Right now we're focused, as I said, on New York. We want to kind of create the best product that we can for New York. But clearly this has the opportunity to go to other cities around the world, and that could be a lot of fun. So you never know where it goes.
So in theory, we could be sitting here right now. Someone could be filming there with their smartphone, and it's a clip. It's a quick drop and upload, or how does it work out?
Yeah, it's a quick drop and upload. Right now, we're encouraging people to film outside in the streets because it's really about public life and street life and not about the intimacy of people's homes. But essentially, you shoot a video, you capture that moment, and you plug it into your computer, you upload it to the site, and it appears on that map. And that's a very simple and easy thing to do, but also has a really large effect. You know, as I was saying earlier, it really gives you a chance to define your own New York. You can bring up the issues that you feel are happening in your city and have people all over the world understand that. And not just have it be an abstract video in a big bucket of unorganized content, but it can really kind of indicate, this is what's happening right here, this is how I feel about it, and this is what I think, and share that with people.
Is there an option for content control? Like, can anyone upload anything at any time, or are there specific benchmarks that must be met with uploading to the website?
So right now it's videos outdoors and on single blocks, and we're not discriminating against anybody's videos, no matter how profound or how simple or how funny or sad or silly they are. So it's really to embrace the diversity of perspectives in New York. So the only reason that we would not allow a video to be on the site is if for some reason it were to, have some sort of illegal content in it. But we're really trying to kind of accept as many videos as possible.
Okay, so when did you, I see this, MyBlockNYC has an installation at MoMA. How did this come about? When did it happen?
MoMA is very exciting because the idea is that if you upload a video to the website, you'll be a filmmaker that's showing in the Museum of Modern Art. So the idea is to bring the streets of the city into the museum for all the museum goers to see, and also to bring the museum closer to the city. It came about because we met with the senior curator of a show called Talk to Me at the Museum of Modern Art. Her name is Paola Antonelli. And we presented her the project, and she thought it was very exciting because it kind of, I think, bridges this gap and tells the narrative of a city in a participatory way, not from any single perspective, but from the collection of perspectives. So it opened up in the MoMA a couple of weeks ago, and it will be there through November. So again, if you upload a video to the website, it will show in the Museum of Modern Art.
I think this is kind of like a local's guide to New York City, getting to know it from like the base level. But I did notice that on the website you have the option to search by crime, by someone's name, by various different parameters. I saw that there were some items where that was shot on the train. How do you see this platform sort of expanding? Will the search get bigger? You know, will you condense it down that people can fit into these five categories? Here's where they stay. Where do you see this going?
I think the biggest challenge for us will be to, as the amount of content on the site grows, for the sophistication of the organization's systems of the site to also grow and adapt based on the content that's coming in. So it's really about listening to the people and watching the videos that are coming in that allow us to shape the site to best, to be the most efficient tool that it can be. So our organization, there is a video right now that's a video that I love. That's actually from a really amazing filmmaker, Charlie Ahern, who made the film Wild Style. But this is, you know, this is just, you know, an eccentric character on Canal Street who has his own style. So this person captured this moment, uploaded it to this site, and now if you're a kid in Tokyo, you can kind of have the feeling of walking down Canal Street and seeing what it really feels like to be on Canal Street, rather than just, you know, a line and a word.
So how long does each movie or does each piece have to be?
We don't limit it by the amount of time. We only limit it by the file size. So as long as it's under 500 megabytes, okay, it can go online.
Okay, so in theory, I could potentially put up a 3-minute piece or?
Yeah, people are putting up 15-minute pieces. Okay. Some people are putting up 15-second moments. Some people are putting up 15-minute documentaries.
Okay.
You know, it really doesn't matter. It's however you're approaching the medium.
So right now, we're actually watching some salsa dancing in the park.
Yeah.
I wonder where that is.
I think, in the Bronx. It'd be much more useful if we were watching the video on the website, because then we would know where it is.
Seems like they're having a good time. So with this stuff, right now, we're only in New York City. Which borough has pretty much dropped in the most videos on your website?
Definitely Manhattan, which is kind of perhaps expected, because that's where we're based, that's where the studios are, and that's where my film community is kind of grounded. But really now it's about putting pressure on the other boroughs beside Manhattan, Bronx, Brooklyn, Queens, Staten Island, to really start representing their boroughs, because each one has its own individual character, and each one is incredibly expressive, and nobody can capture that expressiveness like the people of those boroughs. So we really want those boroughs to really be represented fairly on the map, because if this is something that people from around the world are going to start using to have an understanding of what is New York, what is the sound and culture and style of New York, it's not an honest perspective if it's just Manhattan. So we have to start getting people in the Bronx to easily capture little moments that they see on the streets and upload them to the website and building that new map.
Can you take me when I log on to MyBlockNYC.com?
Yep.
What's my next step?
MyBlockNYC.com. Then on the top of the page, you'll see a login sign up button. Click login sign up. Sign up if you're not already a member. Can you guys still hear me?
I guess.
Go ahead. You can sign up if you're not already a member. And once you've signed up, then you just click the upload button on the top right and select your file and upload it. It's really simple.
So uploading videos are free?
Totally free, yeah.
Okay. So maximum limit is 500 megabytes.
Yeah.
How many videos can you upload for the day?
The more the merrier.
Okay.
Yeah. It's really about kind of like conquering your land. And the more videos that come in, the deeper, you know, of a picture we'll have of New York. And that will be way more interesting and way more fun for people to explore.
Okay, so there we have it. We were watching some video before about, there was like a skateboarder on a bridge. I'm sure the viewers at home got an opportunity to look at it.
Cool.
What kind of camera can I use my iPhone? Can I use my BlackBerry?
Yeah, I mean, the idea is that you no longer need $1 million to make a movie. The equipment is becoming so accessible and so easy to use that whether you have a smartphone with a video camera on it, a digital camera, a friend that has a digital camera, you know, it's not about the quality of the equipment, it's about what you see and capturing that. And that makes it easy for anybody to participate.
Good. So we're encouraging everyone to go out there, film, become those, that next Spielberg or George Lucas or whoever is your idol. Encouraging you to go out there and film your borough. Show love.